Hi guys, welcome back to Relax My Cat. My name is Savannah and here with me is Hex. And today's video is one that I think everyone has wondered about, everyone who's a pet owner, or definitely a cat owner anyway. So yeah, with that said, this week's video is how to stop your cat from getting hairballs. Firstly, I feel like it should be said that you can't completely get rid of hairballs, that's just how cats are. Some cats and some breeds of cat are definitely more prone to them, especially the fluffier ones and the ones that overgroom a lot too, definitely. She's very excitable today, so I don't think she'll sit with me. She's not as calm as a brother. That's just the way that cats are. I know that they're gross, but they do serve a purpose, so it's not good to completely get rid of hairballs. However, that is not to say that you can't minimise hairballs. So first is a given, you should always brush your cat. Most cats are around about once a week that they need brushing, but if you have a really, really fluffy cat, you may find it needs a bit more than that because their fur can get really long and matted, and that can be really painful for them as well, especially when it comes to brushing them out. The good thing about grooming your cat is that the more fur you take out on the brush, the less fur they actually consume, so it just works in minimising the size and the necessity for hairballs. Next is diet and water. It's really, really important that your cat is on a very good diet and they are staying hydrated. Water helps the hair follicles stay nice and healthy, so there's no fur coming out of hair follicles where it shouldn't be coming out. And diet helps keep their coat nice and thick and glossy, again to minimise shedding. If your cat is getting all of the nutrients that they need, their coat, you will see it in their coat, it becomes a lot thicker, glossier, and you'll see that there'll be usually a little bit less shedding as well, obviously depending on the breed of cat and the time of year. But nutrients and water are definitely really big ones in reducing the amount of hairballs that your cat may cough up. She's here, she's just... And lastly, if your cat is really struggling with hairballs, talk to the vet, definitely. When Maya was really struggling with hairballs, we went to the vet and they gave her like this laxative paste. And basically what that did is it bound the hair together in her stomach and helped it pass through the digestive system like with everything else, which made her throat and her mouth a lot healthier as well because she's not coughing up her stomach insides, and it also helped with her the bacterial health, you know, of her intestines as well, which was really helpful at the time. And the vets have a ton of other things like these that can help with the hairballs as well. So yeah, that is it for how to stop hairballs, or minimise hairballs we should say. Thank you so much for watching, as always. And just wanted to say again about our podcast, we're really enjoying doing it. Thank you for everyone who watches. And we'll put the details and everything down in the description for you to find it as well. We're really having fun with it and we hope that you guys... And we hope that you guys like it too. So again, thank you so much for watching and we will see you next week. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I want to say goodbye, Hex. Can't quite figure out where to put your paws, can you? Come here. Come here. You're going to fall.